Hi guys! So today I'm going to share with you three fragrances from my collection that I feel are the most me. So that means that these fragrances were not picked because they're the creme de la creme in my collection or that they're absolute favorites. Though, come to think of it, I've reduced my collection significantly, and so pretty much everything I have at this point is a favorite. But these were picked because they closely reflect my personality, and they're the ones that I identify with. So what do they all have in common to one another? Well, none of them are overly floral, though they do possess a sensuality to them. So I revel in my femininity, but I don't see myself as a girly girl. I have a rough and tough side to me, and I can be quite sarcastic. But yet, I'm sweet and sensitive at the same time. So these are all in the woody and spicy family, and they all appear to have a richness to them, but none of them feel heavy or intimidating to wear. They're all wearable, and they possess a certain effortlessness to them, and they all have a dance and the play between lightness and darkness. So there's a contradiction there, and that they all possess an inner light, an inner glow in them, and that's something I'm really drawn to. So the first one is Maison Francis Gajon Oud. I've already reviewed this fragrance, so if you want to know more about it, I'll link you to the review down below. So the notes are patchouli, cedar, saffron, oud, and elemi, and the main accords are balsamic, oud, warm spicy, woody, and patchouli. So not a hint of flower in this fragrance. Basically, it is an effortless and elegant oody woody fragrance. It really is effortless and light. It doesn't wear you, you wear it. I feel that it brings out the natural beauty of the wearer because it doesn't overwhelm, and it still allows your natural skin scent to shine through the fragrance. And it's done so light and pure that it doesn't have to try very hard. And I read in an interview that Maison Francis Gajon actually considers this one to be his masterpiece. So the second one is Jo Malone Dark Amber and Ginger Lily. So the notes are black cardamom, ginger, pink pepper, jasmine, orchid, water lily, rose, leather, sandalwood, kiara, incense, patchouli, and dark amber. And the main accords are balsamic, warm spicy, woody, fresh spicy, and smoky. This is a sensual and smooth, full-bodied fragrance, but it's never too heavy and it doesn't intimidate. It starts off peppery and spicy, and it sparkles on the skin. Then the dark bouquet of flower complements the warmer amber and wood base, and it brings out the sweetness in the fragrance, and in the background it's just a very light layer of incense, and it's a sensual and rich fragrance, but there is a lightness to it. So last but not least is Olfactive Studio Lumiere Blanche. The notes are cardamom, cinnamon, star anise, iris, cashmere wood, almond, musk, sandalwood, cedar, and tonka bean. And the main accords are woody, warm, spicy, powdery, balsamic, musky, and aromatic. So this, the concept of this fragrance is a whiteness that's joined by the heat from the sun and the coolness of the sea. So the cooling element in this fragrance is the use of cardamom and star anise, and the heat is brought by the cinnamon, and the spices are then sprinkled into a cup of warmed almond milk that is creamy, and the iris and white musk provide a white veil that covers the whole composition. And this is a fragrance that I like to wear in intimate moments or moments when I'm by myself to enjoy this fragrance, because it is a quiet fragrance. But I think in that sense, it makes it the perfect between the sheets scent. And my idea of the perfect between the sheets scent is something that doesn't overwhelm, that is there to really complement the scent of your skin rather than to overwhelm. It should still allow the natural scent of your skin to shine through, and this fragrance does just that. It's sensual, it's elegant, yet it has a lightness to it, and it really is an intimate scent. And this is me when I'm just the most comfortable and myself in my own environment. All right, so that concludes it for today. I would love to hear the perfumes that you closely relate to in your fragrance collection. So please share those with me if you'd like down below. And thanks for watching, and I will see you soon.